There's some very interesting information coming up about the vaccines. It has to do with one dose versus two, or when you time that second dose. We typically, in most vaccination programs, you tend to have a booster shot. It helps in terms of longevity of the immune response. One thing that many people have begun to think about is, you know what? Is that critical to management of the pandemic? And let's just talk for a minute about it. You typically, with these two-dose vaccine schedules, tend to get some significant immune response from the very first dose. So if that's the case, and our rate-limiting step is getting that vaccine manufactured out there and into people's arms, can we delay that second one? There's a lot of evidence that would suggest that we can. So this comes from this article. It was in New York Times. Can we do twice as many vaccinations as we thought? Both Pfizer and Moderna vaccines are supposed to be administered in two doses. They were constructed that way. There's plenty of evidence, though, that even a single dose may provide significant levels of protection against COVID-19. Now, if this were true, it would let us vaccinate up to twice the number of people, not just in the U.S., but in countries where vaccine shortages take years to resolve. For both vaccines, the sharp drop in disease in the vaccination group started about 10 to 14 days after the first dose. And as you may remember, we talked about IgG, IgM, and some of the others. Day 14 to 21 was when IgG started kicking in, and day 7 to 14 was when IgM started kicking in. So you clearly start getting immune responses from antibodies that early. Now, as we know, with this virus, it's not so much the antibody, it's the memory associated with T cells. So is that an indicator that the memory has been developed by our immune system for our T cells? So, for instance, Moderna reported the first dose to be 92.1% effective within 2 weeks after the first shot and before the second injection on the 28th day. Now, should we do a single dose? The data is suggestive. It's limited, though. Vaccine trials were designed to develop a two-dose regimen, not to develop the one-dose regimen. We still do a booster to solidify immune memory. A single dose could protect against disease, but we don't know how long it will protect against disease and at what level. What we know about the immune system in phase one and phase two data suggests older people's immune systems do not respond as strongly. So we may want to think about doing two doses for the older populations and one dose for the younger populations until we can catch up. If we start examining the effectiveness of a single dose now and get the data to support it, we can go forward with it as quickly as possible. Why wait for a disease and hope for a cure? I used to be an ER doc. My name is Ford Brewer. I quit ER after a few years because it was just so frustrating. Most of the things bringing people into the ER are things that should have been prevented, including heart attack, stroke, number one cause of death, number one cause of permanent disability. People think that you're just going to have those and that they're not predictable. Both of those are wrong. They are predictable, and you don't have to have them. Usually it's lifestyle. Lifestyle is more important than supplements and even prescription drugs and even stents and surgery. But the current times are tough. Major financial impact with the lockdowns that most states have been going through. We've been working on a way to make this much more affordable with a subscription process, and that's exactly what we're announcing today. We've got two levels. One is the Silver membership, where you get access to our courses, a private webinar each month, and access to our supplement store and supplement recommendations and prescription. Or I would suggest even more so, the Gold membership. You can get a script for a freestyle Libre and find out what your blood sugar metabolism's doing on a daily basis. And you can get a lab order for inflammation, OGTT, and insulin survey. You can also get a 30-minute one-on-one with me. So I'm looking forward to seeing you. Cost is no longer an excuse. So if you're interested, go to go.prevmedheartrest.com/prevmed-subscription or call us at 859 721-1414, 859-721-1414, or email us at myhealth@prevmedheartrisk.com. Looking forward to seeing you. Thank you.